John, let's talk about Fleury here for a second. You know, we've scored 10 goals in three games against him. He's still making some really nice saves, but we got 10 goals in three games. Now they are really backed up against the wall. They haven't been in this situation for the entire season, certainly the entire postseason. So what do you expect? I mean, this is where you really find out what Vegas is made of. But, man, the Caps roster is so loaded, especially with high-end players that he has to deal with on every shift.
There's a number of things in there, and I agree with you. I mean, when you talk about Fleury and what he's done, his goals against average coming into this series was a little bit more than 1.5. In this series, it is well over 3, which is something he hasn't done, you're right, in three rounds. I look at it, and for Vegas tonight, I agree with you, too, that this you're going to know what they're made of. Either they're going to come off the mat flying, they're going to make adjustments, and they're going to tie the series, or they're going to be on the brink of elimination, and the Caps are going to have 3 chances to win the Cup going to Vegas for Game 5. And obviously we hope it's the latter, but the revenge tour is something that we talked about a lot during the course of this postseason, where the Caps just keep checking things off that, you know, have haunted them in the past. In the first round, it was John Tortorella, who coached the Rangers and beat them multiple occasions. Then you've got Pittsburgh, an upset there. Then you've got Tampa Bay, where they've got all those former New York Rangers. They're half of their defensive core, Stallman and Girardi and McDonough and all the guys that have beaten you in the past. And now you're staring at the guy that has beaten you multiple times, beat you last year when you won the President's Trophy while he was still with Pittsburgh. And this would be the last big check mark, and it's Marc-Andre Fleury. And if you can get to him tonight, 10 goals in 3 games for a guy that was absolutely killing it, that's a lot. And the Caps, by perspective, when they went to the final in 98 in 4 games, they scored a grand total of 7 goals. They're already 3 ahead of pace going into Game 4, and they found a way to get to him. I thought Marc-Andre Fleury was pretty shaky in Game 3. He's one of the best all time. He's won 3 Stanley Cups. I would expect him to be better tonight. But the Caps are feeling it right now, and they're feeling it against him just as they have felt it against anybody that has haunted them in the past. It's worked for 3 rounds. It's worked so far into the 4th round. We'll see if it keeps going tonight.
John Walton, the voice of the Capitals on 106.7 The Fan, joins us on the Mattress Warehouse Hotline. We know how valuable he is, but why don't you highlight our guy, Jay Beagle, and what he means to this team?
Oh, he couldn't. It, the best game I think I've ever seen Jay Beagle play, and I have seen a lot of good performances, and a guy that wins draws and a guy that works as hard as anybody in the sheer hustle just to be able to get up ice, get him the puck. His defensive effort, his effort on the penalty kill, he's one of those guys that you're never – he's never going to sign the big ticket. He's never going to be the guy that takes center stage. But you're a number 2 star of the game in a Stanley Cup final game. He could have been number 1. I mean, with what he did in that game, I thought he was as good as anybody on the ice, and he's doing it at the time of the year when you need him most. And he personifies, I think, a lot, guys, what you see really throughout this entire postseason with this Capitals team. Why are they at this stage? Why are they potentially on the verge of being 1 win away from the Stanley Cup tonight? They're there because you have so many role players at different times who have contributed. Even guys who aren't in the lineup right now, like Alex Chiasson, a huge goal against Pittsburgh. Devontae Smith-Pelly, washed out in 3 different organizations, less than a year ago was bought out by the New Jersey Devils and was without a home. He signs a minimum deal here just to keep his career going. Where would they be without Devontae Smith-Pelly? Where would they be without Jay Beagle? Where would they be without Chandler Stephenson, who cleared waivers at the beginning of this? He could have grabbed him for nothing. And the Caps said, you know what, we don't think you're ready for the NHL. He fought his way back, and now where would they be without him on the PK? I know, and this thing ends, guys, and the Caps win the Cup, there are going to be so many good stories and so many feel-good moments from so many different people. That's the reason they're here. They're just, they've been the better team throughout, and that's what's been so fun to watch.
Hey, John, someone texted me this morning. I don't know the answer to this. What's the relevance of the motorcycle helmet that the guys are wearing in the locker room after the games?
I don't know if anybody's ever, they usually keep that pretty close to the vest. It's funny, the last couple of years, you know, they had the Honest Abe hat, and, you know, it was just kind of, some of it was kind of obvious. I don't know what the significance is. I think if it's been written anywhere, I've missed it. I haven't. We're not down there right after the game, but I'm not sure the answer to that either. It's one of those team things where they just, I'm sure there's a really good reason and a good explanation. I'm imagining if we get a chance to have a parade and a rally, somebody will ask and answer that.
Right.
John, speaking of that, I know you have your travel plans already set for Vegas, but if the Caps are able to grab a 3-1 lead tonight, I'm guessing there are going to be a lot of Caps fans that are booking last-minute trips to Vegas to see the Caps in Game 5 with a potential closeout. Now, I'm getting ahead of myself. They have to take care of business tonight.
Yeah, got
to
win tonight.
But if they win tonight, you're going to see lots of Caps fans on Expedia.com making plans to get out to Vegas ASAP.
Yeah, it's a shame that Vegas is such a boring town. Can you imagine what that trip might be like? If the Caps could win the Cup in Vegas, I'm sure that would be a lot of fun for a lot of people. Let's hope that they have that chance tonight if they get that W.